It was a terrifying sight for an Ankeny family this morning.
Authorities say 24-year-old Benjamin Foster was trying to enter a locked home that was not his. Far from it, as a matter of fact. News Channel 8's Keri Gavin has the story, and quite a surprising twist here, Keri.
That's right. When police looked at Foster's Alabama's driver's license, they asked him what he's doing here in Iowa. He told them he was here as a member of Tim Pawlenty's exploratory committee. Police say he was so intoxicated that he ended up in Ankeny thinking he was in Johnston.
All I hear is screaming, and there's a man. That's all I hear.
It was 3 a.m. Chloe Stewart was sleeping when she was awakened by her 10-pound Yorkie barking and running up and down the stairs.
Ran up from my door, and I stood, like, right here for a second, and he smiled at me, and I, like was in shock for, like, a second, and then I started screaming.
15-year-old Chloe describes what she saw.
And he, like, shoved his arm in here, and he kept touching the wall, looking for something. I don't know what he was looking for.
She ran upstairs to her parents' bedroom. Dad grabbed his gun from the safe and went downstairs.
Guy's still trying to come in with my husband, had a gun on him. And then my husband must have realized that something's not right. You know, he's drunk.
While mom, Stacy, called 911.
My husband's got a gun on him.
Your husband has a gun on him?
But yeah, my husband's in our house. He freaked out my daughter. My daughter came up my stairs screaming because the guy's at the back door trying to get in my house.
Her husband held Foster at gunpoint until police arrived.
Kept telling my husband, I'm trying to find Johnson, Johnson. He just kept saying Johnson. We'll find out he's trying to get to Johnston. He was so drunk, he thought he was at his friend's house.
According to the police report, Foster told police officers he thought he was getting into this house, the house he says he's staying at. This house is owned by State Representative Eric Helland.
I knocked on the door today, but no one answered.
The officer tells me that the gentleman told him that he works for Tim Pawlenty. So I searched him online, found out who he was. Yep, he's from Alabama. He's a some kind of political aide to Tim Pawlenty.
The Stewart family is thankful that Dad realized that Foster was drunk. They know the situation had potential to turn deadly. They're also thankful for Maddie and the metal bar that kept Foster out of their home.
Now, Representative Eric Helland did confirm that Foster is staying with him at his house in Johnston. Today, Foster released this statement saying, quote, last night I made a very serious mistake. I take full responsibility for my actions. I want to apologize to all affected by my poor judgment. I especially apologize to the people who were disturbed during the incident and the arresting officers. I give my word that it will never happen again. A spokesperson for Governor Pawlenty had this to say. Governor Pawlenty is extremely disappointed in Ben's actions, and his behavior does not meet the standards he expects of his employees. Therefore, the committee is placing Ben on a 2-week unpaid suspension and expects him to bear the legal consequences for his actions. Again, Foster was charged with public intoxication and trespassing. His vehicle was found in front of the Stewart's home, but he was not charged with drunk driving because officers found him in their backyard.
Well, Keri, you mentioned he was trying to get to Johnston. He was actually in Ankeny. Do police have any idea where Foster had actually been before he ended up there in Ankeny?
Well, let me tell you that the difference there is 6 miles between the two homes, and he told police that he was drinking at a bar in Des Moines with a friend. As for how he ended up in Ankeny, police say Foster told them he didn't drive, but that a friend drove him to Ankeny, but he wouldn't tell police who that friend was.
All right, Keri, thank you very much.